How are we doing in the trade war? Give us an update.
Well, to begin with, in a way, what dominated the policy discussions in the last few months has been the greatest danger to the growth of the world economy. The skirmish between the two largest economies, US and China. That skirmish had several dimensions, but the most important one is we are talking about a global economy in which the fragments of it are getting apart. What does it mean? The bridges that connect the various parts of the economy are in danger. This affected expectations, it affected mood, it affected plans of capital investment, it affected the plans of where to locate your firm and company in production, because everyone knew if I'm producing in one place and then there will be tariff on my product, I should not produce in that place. We see it already there. Mm-hmm. It is in this regard that the phase one agreement between China and the US was greeted by a measured relief, but also with a note that we still need to see phase two, and political will is here the key.
But nothing was in phase one, apart from a truce of not escalating things further.
Well, what I saw from phase one, it was its very existence. In other words, people understood, even though we cannot deliver to you concrete measures,
right. At
least we tell you, we know that it is important, and therefore we are not burying it. It's not like we withdraw from the climate change treaty.
Yeah.
We are committing to go on, and now the political will comes into the game.
Okay, so that truce, who's it good for, apart from China and the U.S.? So a lot of people said, well, actually, Europe is beneficiary because they were hurt, but what if the U.S. goes after Europe instead of China?
Well, it's a very short-term view to say, these two guys are fighting, and therefore I get some positive spillovers because people change their locations and move to my territory. At the end of the day, there is no way that the world economy can recover in a sustainable way mm-hmm. if the two largest economies are not there in a stable, sustainable way, period. And I think it will be a great mistake to say, let them fight and I'll pick up the pieces and go home happily.
Right.
You will not end up happily.
In the time we've got left, Dr. Frenkel, and you've got real-world experience of this, I find imports and exports, the dialogue in the U.S. is so much about China sending stuff to us, where what I've learned in this trade war is the export dynamics of the United States are really at risk. You live this in Israel, which became an export juggernaut. Are we missing the message here, including the President of the United States? It's not about the stuff coming in from China. It's we have at risk the stuff going out. Is that correct?
Well, the risk is the overall supply chain. In other words, when you are looking at a multilateral world through the lens of a bilateral relationship, you are bound to miss important matters. The world trade system will not be solved by a bilateral nexus. And therefore, even looking at the data and saying, let me look what the import from the United States, from China, and vice versa, this is a very partial question. As long as the U.S. has shortage of savings relatively to investment compared with China, the U.S. will run a deficit and it will spread all over the world. Don't look at a bilateral relationship to determine your macro aggregate problem.